How are polysaccharides and disaccharides digested? The digestion of polysaccharides and disaccharides togetherly, they are carbohydrates. These are the carbohydrates. And students, the digestion of carbohydrates begins in the oral cavity. So here in the oral cavity, the digestion of carbohydrates starts and it continues in the esophagus. But once the food enters into the stomach, in the stomach, the digestion of carbohydrates stops and then it will be resumed in the small intestine. In the small intestine, the complete digestion of carbohydrates takes place. So the digestion of carbohydrates occurs in two places. One is mouth, the other one is small intestine. And the enzymes required for the digestion of carbohydrates are generally called as carbohydrates, a common name. So let's see how the digestion begins in the mouth. As the food enters into the mouth, it mixes with the saliva secreted in the mouth. So the mouth releases saliva, that is the salivary gland secretes saliva. And the salivary glands have an enzyme called salivary amylase. So the salivary amylase present in the mouth acts upon the complex carbohydrate, that is starch, and converts it into its simpler form, that is maltose, isomaltose and dextrin. For this, the required pH is 6.8. And this is obtained by the salts present in the salivary juice. So here, since the food stays only for short duration in the mouth, a partial digestion of carbohydrates occurs. That means it is not completely reduced to its monomer. And the complete digestion takes place in the small intestine. So here you can see the partially digested carbohydrates enters into the small intestine. And the small intestine has the pancreatic juice and the intestinal juice. Now the pancreatic juice contains a carbohydrate digesting enzyme called pancreatic amylase. So amylase is nothing but the carbohydrate digesting enzyme. It acts upon the polysaccharide and it breaks them into disaccharides. So here we can see this is one monosaccharide, this is the other. So when both are linked together, we call it as disaccharide. So a polysaccharide is broken down into disaccharide. So amylase converts starch into disaccharides. And later, the intestinal juice, which is secreted by the small intestine, they have enzymes which breaks the disaccharides. And these enzymes are maltase, lactase and sucrase. So they act upon the disaccharides and break the bond, releasing the monosaccharides. And these monosaccharides will be taken into the lymphatic vessels and they are transported to the various parts of the body. Now the disaccharides present are maltose, lactose and sucrose. So maltose contains 2 glucose, lactose contains 1 glucose and 1 galactose, sucrose contains 1 glucose and fructose. So the maltase enzyme acts upon maltose and releases 2 glucose molecules. Lactase acts upon lactose sugar and converts it into glucose and galactose. Sucrose will be acted by the enzyme sucrase and it releases glucose and fructose. Now all these things, glucose, galactose, fructose are monosaccharides. So these are all monosaccharides and these monosaccharides will be absorbed by the blood vessels and will be transported. So this is how the polysaccharide will be converted to monosaccharides. The polysaccharides and disaccharides digested in the mouth and the intestine. So the carbohydrate digestion begins in the mouth and it completes in the intestine. In the mouth, there is salivary amylase which breaks the carbohydrates. In the intestine, there is pancreatic amylase which digests the carbohydrates into disaccharides. And these disaccharides are further broken down by maltase, lactase and sucrase to get the monomers, that is glucose, galactose and fructose.